Honestly speaking, a dude owed me some money, and he was ducking me. And every time I would call, you know, phone doesn't get answered, I go knock on the door, he's not here. We're not gonna keep playing that game. So after my patience wore thin, I went over there, knocked on the door, and nobody answered it, so I kicked it open. And when I came out of the place, police was coming down the street. I couldn't get to the car, so I ran. So they chased me through a few backyards, so I ended up taking a flat 7. Well, I grew up in prison, man, from like the time I was old enough to go. I did a Rikers Island stint in 83. I went upstate in 85. I came home in 88. I went back upstate in 88, maybe like 7 months later. Stayed in jail till about December 92. I stayed home from 92 to like 2001. 2001, I went back to prison for 6 years, came home and did a year. So my criminal history is lengthy. I mean, like, if you have no family members and you go to jail, nobody in the whole world knows you're alive. It's like a cemetery for the breathing.
Get down! Paid the cost to be the boss.
Paid the cost to be the boss. So when he was in prison, he got a certificate to do asbestos abatement. And so when he came home, he was very, very optimistic about getting a job. And he learned that the certificate that he got while he was in prison wasn't valid in New York City because it was issued by a county upstate and there wasn't reciprocity. He had to take a test in New York City to get it. So I says, okay, let's take it. Go take it. Go take it.
I didn't pass it. And I went and I took the test again. And I didn't pass it. Kept missing it by like 1 point.
And so he came into my office and he was dejected, and I was like resisting him being dejected, and I was like all like, come on, put your big boy pants on, let's go here, come on, you're gonna take that test again, let's go, we'll get the money, you did it before, you can do it again. So where's the study guide? Did you get the study guide? And he goes, there is no study guide. And I'm like, Gales, there, nobody's this unlucky. You are attracting gloom and doom, and get the study guide. And he goes, I'm telling you, there is no study guide. And I'm like, Gales, do you think I'm an idiot? What is that, impossible? How can there be no study guide for an examination that the city of New York is giving? See, you idiot, watch this. It's called 311. It's a new thing, 311. You call this number. And so it's like, hello, 311. Transfer, give me the number, call them up. Hey, I want to take that test. Where's the study guide? What do you mean there's no study guide?
I'm probably going to sell some drugs. I'm probably going to do something.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm not going to lie to you. I'm probably going to sell some drugs.
Yeah.
But it's the quickest fix. They put money in your pocket on a daily basis, you know what I mean? I'm always fighting that. It's hard, but it could be worse, you know? So, and he tells me that all the time. You know, you survived prison, you was in the box for 23 hours a day for like a whole 12 months. If you can survive that, you can survive anything, you know? And so I think, like, when I'm walking out the hall, I'll be like, yeah. At the moment, I don't want to hear that. But when I leave the office and I'm walking down the street, and a girl comes by with a nice fat ass, I could say, well, he may have a point.
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling around the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when.
I've always known right from wrong, you know? But for whatever the reason, I just didn't give a shit, you know? I can blame it on a million things, but at the end of the day, I did what I did, you know? So I guess now, at this late stage in the game, I don't want to go back there, but I don't want to grow old and die in jail. So I've reached the point where that's either going to be the reality or I'm going to try and make some sort of a transformation and turn my life around to some degree, you know, and live the rest of my days out here as opposed to in there.
I hang my head and cry.